Hi, this is Dr. Nemechek. I want to discuss with you how the Nemechek Protocol helps children with autism, developmental delay, sensory processing disorder, apraxia, ADD, and ADHD. The important aspect of all of these conditions is that the normal brain development, the normal brain repair mechanisms are being negatively affected by a chemical inflammatory state that's actually a problem in most people in the population. And adults, we're now referring to this as inflammaging. There's a video about that as well you could watch. But these chemicals, they're called pro-inflammatory cytokines, are preventing the brains from of these children from developing correctly and from repairing kind of rather common injuries. Now, a child's brain on the first level in terms of injury repair, we call this cumulative brain injury. I discussed this at length in the protocol guide. But cumulative brain injury is a damage to neurons in the head. So if you hit your head, you'll snap some neurons, okay? From just very common things. Your child doesn't have to be knocked unconscious. You know, I always joke that it seems like every family reunion I've ever been to, there's some little kid crying because they hit their head. Okay, now those kids have a minor brain injury, and if everything works fine, within 2-3 weeks, it's completely healed and nobody even notices anything. But if you have this inflammatory process, you leave a little bit of damage behind. Get it here so you can see it, okay? And then if this keeps going, you leave some more damage on your next injury, and then more and more. And this damage slowly starts building, and that's what we call cumulative brain injury. Now, the injuries can also be from emotional trauma, very traumatic events, okay, very frightening events we now know cause damage to neurons, and it's damage you can see in a microscope. Yeah, shocking, but it's true. Then there's also inflammatory damage. This can be from inflammation from a severe infection, the stress of surgery, from fractures, and even from vaccines can do this. This is part where the vaccines come in and can cause some problems. And so all these kind of injuries won't get repaired correctly because of inflammation. Now, the other thing that happens is a child's born with 100 billion neurons, and we need to get those 100 billion neurons pruned down to 50 billion by the time you're 18, all right? And as you go along, that's how a child hits their milestones. That's how they walk at the right time, talk at the right time, and so forth. And so but if you have inflammation, the neuron, these white blood cells in the brain called microglia, they do not prune correctly. So the rate of pruning slows down. That's your developmental delay. And interestingly, we're now learning these enrichment exercises, as we call them, speech therapy, you know, OT, PT, all this kind of stuff. They improve the pruning rate, okay? And so even the benefit they give us is about pruning. So now, where does this inflammatory stuff come from? It comes from a couple major sources. I should add one other thing is, if you have now autism, you have cumulative brain injury, you have poor pruning, so you have both developmental delay and things like, so the cumulative brain injury in kids gives you ADD and hyperactivity, the intense anxiety that we call stimming and things like that, okay? And then in addition, their intestinal bacteria is making a chemical called propionic acid, and this makes the kids, I describe propionic acid as kind of like a cross between Valium and LSD. It's a sedative, and it also causes some very strange behaviors for these children. But anyhow, the sources of we'll come back to that in a minute. The sources of this inflammation are coming from a couple places. One very common source is from excessive omega-6 fatty acids, which are inflammatory. Most of these are coming in through the food supply from common vegetable oils like sunflower and safflower and soy and corn and margarine and shortening and things of that nature. They're coming in through the meats we eat, because we know if you feed fish corn and soybeans, you're feeding them corn oil and soy oil, and it gets converted into a different omega-6, and this is enough to cause brain injury, okay? We have a number of studies in animals now that are starting to show this. But fortunately, this part of the inflammatory stress we block with olive oil. It contains an omega-9 called oleic acid. So the omega-9 is capable in oleic acid in the olive oil is capable of completely blocking this inflammatory stress we're seeing from these omega-6 fatty acids. Okay, so olive oil is a very important aspect of reducing inflammation in the brain in these children. It's a critical part of reducing inflammation in my adult patients to get their brains to recover. The other aspect is the deficiency of omega-3 fatty acids that we have in our diet. And this is not just the omega-3 called alpha-linoleic acid, or ALA. That's what's in flax and nuts, things of that sort. We need a critical omega-3 called DHA. And this predominantly comes from animal tissue and is in high concentrations in fish, all right? So the kids need omega-3 fatty acids. So the omega-6s are increase inflammation, okay? And so we block that with the olive oil, and then we give the kids more omega-3 fatty acids from fish oil. These reduce inflammation. So both of these help a lot. Now the final piece is fixing the inflammatory stress and the propionic acid production that's coming out of the small intestine. There's a condition called bacterial overgrowth, or SIBO, small intestine bacterial overgrowth. And this is where the bacteria from the colon are living now up in the small intestine. Whereas I put it in my protocol, this is where the fish, bacteria in the colon, are living up with the birds, all right? And this causes a lot of inflammatory stress and produces, in some cases, propionic acid, which gives you the features of autism. So really the difference between autism and a kid with developmental delay and cumulative brain injury is just the chemical, all right? Take away the chemical and the autism features go away. Now you're just left with developmental delay and cumulative brain injury. So how do we fix the intestinal bacteria? Well, in the young ones, and generally this is almost every kid below 10, and you can actually get some of the kids up to the early teenage years to respond to this, is we use a prebiotic fiber called inulin. There are a lot of fibers out there. They are not the same, okay? This one is inexpensive. It's readily available. It's cheap. Just stick with this one. Don't try to do something else. Just this one works, and that's all we need, okay? And think of inulin like bird food. In small amounts, it will only feed the natural bacteria that live in the small intestine. They undergo what's called a fermentation process, and because of that, they make acid, all right? Now, the invading bacteria from the colon that I refer to as the fish bacteria, they do not like acid, and they will regress. And as they regress, you get less inflammation and your propionic acid levels go down, okay? And when those propionic acid levels go down, you get the awakening. I'll come back to that in a minute. Now, if you have an older kid, for reasons we don't fully understand, that as you get up into the teens and certainly as an adult, the inulin is not effective enough to really get good brain recovery, so we use rifaximin, all right? This is a non-absorbable antibiotic. All this drug can do is sweep the fish bacteria out of the small intestine, and it leaves the birds behind. It does not harm the fish bacteria in the colon, the lower part. The drug just does not work there. And so we don't have to worry about the same issues we do with other antibiotics. It will not lower the species count or kind of worsen the gut bacteria issue in the gut. This just simply reorganizes the bacteria. And as I said, in the mid to late teens up to adulthood, you gotta use this to get good brain recovery. So olive oil, fish oil, and reorganizing the gut with either inulin in the young ones or rifaximin in the older ones has this tremendous ability to reduce inflammation. And what happens is it restores the brain's natural ability to start pruning again and to start to repair the cumulative brain injury. And it makes the propionic acid levels go away. So now when the propionic acid levels go away, if you have autism, what you'll see is called the awakening, because the propionic acid can act kind of like a sedative, like Valium, okay? And when you use the inulin, the propionic acid levels drop. If you think of it as the Valium dosage drops, if you may get more anxious behavior. They don't sleep as well, they're more anxious, they're more irritable, they're more hyper, all right? That is not from the inulin. What it's doing is showing you the depth of the injury you have underneath, all right? You take kids, and if you just give them rifaximin without any inulin, you get the exact same effect, okay? It's from removing the propionic acid, you see this. Now, in about 4, 6, maybe 8 weeks, depending on how observant the parents are and the nature of kind of the dysfunction you have, you're gonna start to see recovery. This is gonna start to go away, all right? You just gotta get through that period, and it can certainly be a challenge, but it will start recovering. And so that's really the basis of the Nemechek Protocol. We are delighted. It's having such a wonderful effect on everybody. It's inexpensive. It's very safe. I should also add, you absolutely don't use any probiotics with this. And I counsel everybody, you get rid of all the other non-prescription supplements, non-prescription vitamins, because they are very frequently, in the work we're doing with many of the children around the world, getting in the way of these kids recovering. I don't know exactly if it's because some of these supplements are fraud and they contain something that's harmful to the children, or it's just the brains of these small children are just that strained, that inflamed, that sensitive, that if you trickle in just a little something, even like lysine or zinc, we've seen kids who've learned to finally speak relapse within a few days of these supplements. So we only need enough, which is olive oil, fish oil, and organizing the gut, all right? Now, if a child's on medicine for seizures, prescriptions, you would keep those in place, obviously, right? That's what I say. So non-prescription supplements. You cannot get the brain to recover, speed up. You can't speed up the recovery of the brain. If you break your arm, all right, it takes 6 weeks for the bone to heal. Why? Because the bone takes 6 weeks. We have no way to speed that up. It's a thing of nature. The brain has its own rate of recovery. Now, you might be begging for the speech to occur and think nothing's happening, but all around, the child's doing different things. They're sleeping better. They're communicating better. They're playing with their siblings. You know, all these things are happening. As long as you see those things happening, all right, the speech will come. You got to hang in there, all right? So, again, this is Dr. Nemechek. On behalf of myself and my wife, Jean, we're delighted you're all doing so well. And you just got to hang in there, stick to the protocol. You need to read the protocol, all right? There's a lot you can learn. There's stuff about relapsing, these little bumps in the road down the road that you're going to need to understand. And we're just really delighted everybody's doing so wonderfully with the protocol. Y'all have a great day. Bye-bye.